Sleepy Time Tales. Pearl, Squirrel, and the Missing Walnuts. Aunt Fluffy had forgotten where her walnuts were buried. "Gracious me," she exclaimed. "I've got company coming and no walnuts. I'd give a whole pie to whomever could find them." "I'll find them for you," said Pearl Squirrel. Pearl Squirrel ran to where Aunt Fluffy thought the walnuts might be buried. But Farmer Carter's dog, Peabody, was already there. Barking, woof, 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 and howling, Peabody ran towards Pearl, who quickly scrambled up the tree. "Hush up," Pearl scolded.
"I won't," snarled Peabody. "You're just the little squirrel I want for some squirrel stew.
If you'll leave me alone, I'll show you where a wonderful dinner is buried," Pearl said. The thought of a beefy bone filled Peabody's head.
"It's a deal," he growled. "Where do I dig?"
Pearl pointed to a mossy mound. "There," said Pearl. Peabody dug and dug. Dirt flew from behind his hind legs. But that was all. "There's nothing in this hole but dirt," growled Peabody at last. "Maybe I made a mistake," said Pearl. "Dig over by that log." Again, Peabody's big paws set to work. Rocks flew out from between his legs, but that was all.
"There's nothing in this hole but rocks," Peabody snapped.
"Well, try digging between the roots of that beech tree," Pearl suggested. Peabody started digging again. This time, oodles and noodles of walnuts came flying up.
"There isn't any bone in this hole either," Peabody sighed, all tuckered out. "And now I hear Farmer Carter calling me. I haven't even time to chase you. Goodbye for now."
Pearl laughed and called after him. "Thanks for digging up a wonderful dinner, Peabody."
"Dinner for us squirrels, that is."
Pearl collected all the walnuts Peabody had dug up and delivered them to Aunt Fluffy for her pies. And Pearl ate the biggest pie all by herself. On the last night of the trip, Ruby Rabbit, Pearl Squirrel, and Ollie Otter were allowed to stay up very late to watch the meteor showers. They were all bundled up in their sleeping bags, staring up at the sky. "Uncle Arthur," asked Ollie, yawning, "can you make up a story about me?" So Uncle Otter told a story about how Silly saved Ollie Otter. Ollie Otter was on his way to his favorite river bank slide. Suddenly, Wally Wolf leaped out from behind a tree and grabbed his tail.
"Gotcha!" Wally cried. "Just try and get away."
But Ollie didn't move. He smiled and rolled over on his back.
"Thank goodness you came along, Wally," Ollie said. "You can put an end to my troubles."
"Troubles?
What's wrong?" asked the wolf.
"I've just come from the doctor. From Dr. Owl's," he said. Ollie started to cry.
"You're sick, aren't you?" asked Wally Wolf.
"Gravely," Ollie answered. He said, "I had the most serious case of the sillies that he had ever seen." Ollie burst out crying again.
"What does it feel like to have the sillies?" Wally asked nervously.
"Oh," yelled Ollie as he twisted into a ball and flipped himself over.
"Yeah," he groaned, somersaulting back and collapsing again. It makes your side aches, Oli murmured. Then it makes you cry.
How do you catch the sillies? Asked Wally, anxiously, backing away from the otter.
You catch it from something that already has it. It must have been that fish I ate for lunch, Ollie sobbed.
Please, Mr. Wolf, gobble me up and end my misery, Ollie said, closing his eyes.
But all was silent. Ollie jumped up and started to laugh. He laughed and laughed till his sides began to ache. Ollie laughed until tears streamed down his face. But they weren't sad tears at all. They were glad tears that he had tricked Wally Wolf into letting him go free. The end.